स्टार्टिंग विद दिस फर्दर, हम लोगों ने फर्स्ट डिजीजेस एंड इट्स टाइप्स एंड द वेरियस कॉजेटिव एजेंट एंड व्हाट द वेरियस सिम्टम्स ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर डिजीजेस, व्हाट द मेथड्स ऑफ द स्प्रेड, ये सारी चीजें हम लोग पढ़ चुके हैं अभी तक, ठीक है, रिलेटेड विद द डिजीजेस. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद वाज द इम्यूनिटी. यस्टरडे जस्ट अ स्मॉल लिटिल इंट्रोडक्शन टाइप आई गिव यू फॉर दिस. वॉट इज इम्यूनिटी? दैट इज द एबिलिटी टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द पर्टिकुलर diseases. Okay, when the organism is able to fight against a particular diseases, we say it's immunity. That is, a particular person is having a good immunity, you know. We also took the example that of the sufferers of the common cold, you know. The common cold mein humne example liya, as if 30 students are there, let's say, in a class, and one out of the 30 student is a sufferer of common cold, the other 29, they are not getting that common cold as from the air also, because it is an infectious disease, you know, common cold ek infectious disease hai. But agar air ke through us ek class mein, ek hi room mein, agar ek infected person aur baki jo uninfected persons baithe hain, still the 29 others, they are not getting that particular disease. Means the immunity of that particular jo 29 students hain, unki immunity is stronger hai, theek hai? That is why they are not getting that disease, right? What makes this immunity stronger? That is your diet. That is your eating habits, as well as the exercises, meditation, yogas. Okay, so these are the good habits that particularly enhances or boosts up your immunity, as it is required nowadays also. That is for your these prevailing situations of the COVID. So the immunity must be a good one. For that, we need to avoid the junk food, and we need to have the daily healthy diet, which is having the fruits and the vegetables and the salads, especially also doing the regular exercises and the yogas and everything, that will also boost up the immunity. Okay, now continuing with our topic of this NCRD, that is immunity. Further, we have studied that is of two types. What are the various types of this immunity? They are of two types of the immunity. That is the one which we get by birth, that is called as a innate immunity, and the one that we acquire during our lifespan, that is what we call it as a acquired immunity. What is this innate immunity? That is the one which we get by birth. Okay, innate, that is inborn. When you were born, there was certain immunity that was there within your body, and that is the innate immunity. Okay, acquired, that is which is achieved during the lifespan. Okay, during the life, the person achieves, depending upon the requirement of this, that is called as acquired immunity. Okay, innate one, that is not specific for the pathogens. So this is a non-specific type of immunity for pathogens, because this is a kind of immunity which is created for all the type of the pathogens. Means our first innate immunity is created by our skin, right? That is a physical barrier. This innate immunity is created in the form of the barriers, okay, and this is the immunity which is created in the form of the cells or the you can say proteinaceous compounds that which are present in our body. So this is also a difference between innate and acquired. Firstly, this is a non-specific immunity which is for the pathogens. The skin is providing an immunity, that is, it is providing a barrier. It is not for only a single particular type of the microbe. It is for all the microbes not to enter inside our body, you know, through the skin, right? So that is why it is called as a non-specific immunity type for the pathogens. Whereas this is specific. For example, if we talk about the chickenpox, okay, so chickenpox, that is a disease initially which is not triggered. The antibodies are not triggered within our body, but later on, the antibodies, they are memorized within our the pathogen is memorized within our body, and then the antibodies will be generated later on the second attack of the same pathogens, you know. So that is the antibodies which were produced by our own body, they were the ones which were specific to that particular organism causing the chickenpox, you know. So this is specific for pathogens. Jo acquired immunity hoti hai, that is usually specific for the pathogens. Okay, it is non-specific for the pathogens, innate one, whereas acquired is specific for the pathogens. Okay, so with these, aap yahan pe bhi likh sakte ho, it is given in the form of, then another difference between the two, it is given in the form of, or it is there in the form of barriers within the human body, whereas the acquired one, that is in the form of, in the form of cells, in the form of either cells or the proteinaceous structures called as antibodies, that which produces the acquired immunity. And this difference is clear. So we shall start further with the information of this. Any question till this? Any doubt? Okay, done. So now continuing with the innate immunity. For the innate immunity, there are various methods, that is by the barriers. We said that it is produced by the barriers. So the very first barrier, that is the physical barrier. First is a physical barrier. For example, that of the skin. Okay. Examples are skin and mucus. The examples for this are skin and mucus. The mucus coating, that which is seen in the respiratory tract or within the urogenital tracts, right? So those tracts, they are also having their lining with the mucus. The mucus and the skin, they provide the first type of the innate immunity, that is the physical barrier, that is in the form of the physical barriers. Okay, this is not allowing the particular microbes to enter within our body, right? For the natural openings, like there are eyes, right? Or there is a respiratory tract. The respiratory tract is also coated with this mucus lining, right? There are certain other chemicals which are also secreted by the various parts of our body. Or like in the eyes, there are tears which are being produced, right? That cleans out all the microbial materials, or we can say that actually helps to get rid of all the microbial entries from outside to inside of our body, right? And that marks the second type of this barrier for innate immunity. And the second type of the barriers are physiological barriers. The first are the physical barriers, second are the physiological barriers. Physiological barriers, for example, the acid produced within your stomach. Acid within the stomach, or we can say the tears which are produced within our eyes. Okay, so tears within eyes. These type of the secretions produced, they provide the physiological barrier. Okay, so first type is a physical barrier, second are the physiological barrier, third are the cellular barriers. Certain cells also create the barriers, that is, they do not allow the microbes to enter into our body system, right? So that are the cellular barriers. You must have heard of the functioning of the macrophages, right? In the ninth class, especially when we teach you the tissues, mein hum log aapko macrophages bhi batate hain, unka phagocytic action batate hain. If any of the microbes that crosses the skin lining and it comes in contact with the other tissue linings, there are present the macrophages. That macrophages has a phagocytic action, that which are going to engulf the particular microbes and hence creating the barrier for their entry further into our body. Na? To aage nahi jate, into internal organs nahi ja pate. So other cells also, like that of the PMNL, there is a cell that is a kind of the leukocytes, which are called as PMNL ki full form. आपको पूछी जाती है बहुत बार. सो दिस इज पॉलीमॉर्फो न्यूक्लियर लिम्फोसाइट्स, नो लिम्फोसाइट्स नहीं, ल्यूकोसाइट्स. दीज आर ल्यूकोसाइट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज पीएमएनएल, दैट आर द पॉलीमॉर्फो न्यूक्लियर ल्यूकोसाइट्स. और द अदर सेल्स लाइक दैट ऑफ द मोनोसाइट्स आर देयर. And even the macrophages, which I talked about, macrophages. So these are a few type of the cells that which help in either killing of natural killer cells bhi hote hain within this category, that is of the cellular barriers, natural killer cells. Okay, you can write those also. So the cellular barriers, they are actually including the different cells which are having their phagocytic actions, killing actions, so that they can stop the entry of the pathogens within our body. Okay, so these are the cellular barriers. The fourth are the interferons, that are the cytokine secretions. So the interferons, which are साइटोकाइन बैरियर लिख सकते हो आप इसको, या इंटरफेरॉन्स, इंटरफेरॉन. सो व्हाट आर द इंटरफेरॉन्स? दीज आर द केमिकल्स व्हिच आर सेक्रेटेड बाय द वायरस इन्फेक्टेड सेल्स. द ऑलरेडी इन्फेक्टेड सेल्स, जो वायरस इन्फेक्टेड सेल्स हैं, वो क्या करते हैं, कुछ केमिकल्स सेक्रेट करते हैं सो दैट उनके साइड वाले जो सेल्स है, मतलब जो ऑलरेडी एक सेल वायरस से इन्फेक्ट हो चुका है, तो उनके साथ लगे सेल्स जो हैं वो इन्फेक्ट ना हो जाए. सो दिस इन्फेक्टेड सेल इज गोइंग टू सिक्रीट सर्टन केमिकल्स एज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द इंटरफेरॉन्स एंड दैट प्रोवाइड्स अ बैरियर अगेन, एंड द बैरियर विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द साइटोकाइन बैरियर. यू कैन बेटरली राइट इट एज द साइटोकाइन बैरियर एंड देन गिव द एग्जाम्पल. ठीक है, दैट इज ऑफ द इंटरफेरॉन्स. गिव द हेडिंग एज साइटोकाइन बैरियर. साइटोकाइन बैरियर and then the example that of the virus infected cells, that which produces the interferons and hence leading to the leading to the further viral infection, from stopping the further viral infection, that is preventing the further viral infection to the subsiding cells, that is the barrier which is called as a cytokine barrier created by the interferons, the chemicals created by the virus infected cells. Okay, so these are the four types of the barriers: physical, physiological, cellular and cytokine. Okay, so these are the four types of the barriers along with their examples, how they are preventing the human body from getting infected or from the attack of the pathogens for the diseases. Okay, this is called as the innate immunity. These barriers are responsible for causing the innate immunity. Now if we say they were present by birth, are here any of the components that which can't be which is you can say they are not given to the human body from birth, since birth, you know, before the birth they have been introduced within our body, these features, these things, they have been already produced within our body, the acid, the tears and everything, and they are hence helpful in creating the immunity. Okay, now what if the pathogen is acting smart and the pathogen has survived all through from these particular things and now it is creating the damage to the inside of our body. ठीक है, तो उसने ये सारे barriers जो हैं उसको मतलब खत्म कर दिया है pathogen ने, and now it is going within our body, and how the immunity will be created within our body. First is created by the cells only, ना जो वहां पे cells fight करेंगे. ठीक है, तो उनमें cells में भी हम लोग यहाँ पे पढ़ रहे हैं as these are PMNL cells or the monocytes or the macrophages. These cells are also to kill the microbes within the body. ठीक है, microbial actions को खत्म करने के लिए भी within the body these are also the barriers. Okay, coming to the next, that is when the immunity is either triggered by itself within our body or it is generated through certain particular outside resources, that is called the acquired. Means during the lifespan, now the person is in requirement of the extra immunity, okay, which was not given initially, but needs the something else, extra type of the immunity for the survival, that is during the lifespan. So that is all included under the acquired immunity. Acquired immunity. Okay. First of all, before studying that what is this acquired immunity because of and how it is produced, we should know that the acquired immunity will be as generated in response to the you can say the responses which are created by the pathogen into our body. Right. Firstly, let's say जैसे मैंने अभी यहाँ पे example लिया था that of the चिकन पॉक्स, है ना. तो चिकन पॉक्स में क्या हुआ, फर्स्ट टाइम द पैथोजन हैज अटैक्ड द ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड द पर्सन गेट सफर्ड विद द चिकन पॉक्स, राइट. तो वहां पे पहला रिस्पॉन्स आया हमारी बॉडी का, जिसमें जब पैथोजन ने हमारी बॉडी को अटैक किया तो हमारी बॉडी ने रिस्पॉन्स क्या दिया, दैट इज इट गॉट द डिजीज एंड इट स्टार्टेड शोइंग द वेरियस सिम्टम्स. सो दिस वॉज द रिस्पॉन्स विच वॉज इनिशियली मेड बाय अवर बॉडी. सो वेन द pathogen attacked at first, okay, with the first attack of the pathogen, when our body is responding, this is called as a primary response. And with respect to the disease of chickenpox, what was the primary response? That we or the organism whose body was attacked by the pathogens of the chickenpox, that got the disease and showed the symptoms, you know, watery pustules and everything, fever, high fevers and everything. So वैसे वाले जो symptoms हैं वो आने शुरू हो जाते हैं बॉडी में एज अ रिस्पॉन्स. बट आफ्टर दैट पर्टिकुलर डिजीज, देर आर सर्टन मेमरी सेल्स है ना दैट कीप्स ऑन मेमोराइजिंग द थिंग्स फॉर विच द इनिशियली द एंटीबॉडीज वर नॉट प्रोड्यूस्ड. इनिशियली एंटीबॉडीज हमारे पास चिकन पॉक्स के हमारी बॉडी के अंदर नहीं होते हैं. ठीक है, जैसे अभी ये पहले से बाय बर्थ मिले हैं तो वो नहीं मिले हैं हमें. ठीक है, अब ऐसे में इम्यूनिटी को एक्वायर किया जाएगा या तो किसी एक्सटर्नल रिसोर्सेज से या फिर इंटरनली ये खुद बनाएगा. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी. ओके, अब एक्सटर्नल रिसोर्सेज नहीं, हम यहाँ पे अपनी खुद की प्रिपरेशन की बात कर रहे हैं उसकी. आफ्टर दिस व्हेन द सेकेंड टाइम द सेम पैथोजन दैट अगेन अटैक द सेम ऑर्गेनिज्म सेम पेशेंट सेम पर्सन जिनको पहले चिकन पॉक्स हो चुका था, जब वापस फिर से वही पैथोजन ने अटैक किया तो पहले रिस्पॉन्स में एक एडिशनल चीज आई थी कि सिम्टम्स तो उसने शो किए थे बट एक एडिशनल और क्या था साथ में कि हमारी बॉडी के मेमरी सेल्स के अंदर दिस एंटीजन स्ट्रक्चर वॉज लॉक्ड. ठीक है, बिकॉज ऑफ विच इफ नाउ द सेम एंटीजन कुड अटैक अगेन नाउ अवर बॉडी कैन प्रोड्यूस एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट इट. तो प्राइमरी रिस्पॉन्स ये आया, एक तो एक्सटर्नल रिस्पॉन्स दे दिया उसने सिम्टम्स की फॉर्म में, एक इंटरनल रिस्पॉन्स रखा जो था इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द मेमोरी सेल्स. ठीक है, तो वो मेमोरी सेल्स ने अब सेकेंड टाइम जब भी ट्रिगर हुआ वही वाला एक्शन तो तब क्या होगा, उसने सेकेंडरी रिस्पॉन्स क्रिएट किया. सेकेंडरी रिस्पॉन्स क्रिएट करते ही फिर से एंटीबॉडीज प्रोड्यूस होंगे. ठीक है, सेकेंडरी रिस्पॉन्स में क्या आएगा, एंटीबॉडीज विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड एंड दोज एंटीबॉडीज नाउ विच आर प्रोड्यूस्ड अगेंस्ट द सेम पैथोजन सेम एंटीजन, तो वो अब उस पैथोजन को खत्म करेंगे एंड हिंस द सेम पर्सन इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट द चिकन पॉक्स बैक अगेन. दिस इज द इम्यूनिटी विच अ पर्सन हैज एक्वायर्ड इन द लाइफ टाइम, है ना, लाइफ स्पैन में. मतलब उसने एक बार ट्रिगर होने के बाद, इस डिजीज के होने के बाद उसने अपने से एक इम्यूनिटी क्रिएट किया. दैट इज इट हैज एक्वायर्ड, इट वॉज नॉट गिवन बाय बर्थ, it has acquired during its lifespan. ठीक है, the secondary responses which are generated they are also called as anamnestic responses. ठीक है, anamnestic responses क्या है, anamnestic anamnestic responses or the secondary responses which are created after the first response when the same pathogen is going to trigger the same action in the same organism back again. Okay, so this is okay, clear? ये पता चला acquired कैसे है, या तो external resource से होगा या internally, जैसे हमने ये वाला case पढ़ा अपने आप से बन गया. ठीक है, internal में अगर हम बात करें तो acquired immunity that is also given by the two types of the cells that which are involved, two types of cells that which are involved and their actions are involved providing the acquired immunity. What are those two types of the cells? They are the B lymphocytes and the T lymphocytes, right? The B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. Now the B lymphocytes, they are going to produce the antibodies. जो मैं इतनी देर से बोली जा रही हूँ, ये antibodies generate हुई एंटीजन के अगेंस्ट हुई, तो ये एंटीबॉडीज कौन प्रोड्यूस करता है, बी लिम्फोसाइट्स. टी लिम्फोसाइट्स आर डायरेक्टली नॉट इन्वॉल्वड इन सेक्रेटिंग दीज एंटीबॉडीज बट दे हेल्प द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स इन प्रोड्यूसिंग दीज. ठीक है, जो हमने बात करी थी ना अभी, मेमोराइज कर लिया, तो टी मेमोरी सेल्स होते हैं, तो ये टी हेल्पर सेल्स होते हैं, टी किलर सेल्स होते हैं, जो कि हेल्प करते हैं बी लिम्फोसाइट्स को इन एंटीबॉडीज को प्रोड्यूस करने के लिए, ताकि जैसा एक्शन रिक्वायर्ड हो वैसे ही एंटीबॉडीज क्रिएट हो जाएं एंड आर बॉडी कैन फाइट अगेंस्ट अ पर्टिकुलर पैथोजेंस और द एंटीजेंस. क्लियर? ठीक है, दैट इज द एक्शन ऑफ द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स. द एंटीबॉडीज दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द प्रोटीन. वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स दैट प्रोड्यूसेस एन आर्मी ऑफ द प्रोटीन्स, आर्मी ऑफ द सोल्जर्स, प्रोटीनिशियस फाइटर्स सोल्जर्स विच आर कॉल्ड एज द एंटीबॉडीज. Clear. The T lymphocytes, they are initially involved in generating or in helping the B lymphocytes. Also, there are the two types of the immunities under the acquired one, which help, which are generated by the B lymphocytes as well as the T lymphocytes. What is the type of the immunity that is acquired immunity? The type of the immunity which is created by the B lymphocytes. It is called as HMI. HMI. That is humoral mediated immune response या immunity. Okay, what is it? I'm writing over here. If you can see, इट इज ह्यूमोरल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी और इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेस. ठीक है, दिस इज HMI और ह्यूमोरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेस और ह्यूमोरल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी. ओके, ऑल्सो द टी लिम्फोसाइट्स दे आर प्रोड्यूसिंग द CMI, दैट इज अ सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी. ओके, सो दिस प्रोवाइड्स द अनदर टाइप ऑफ द इम्यूनिटी विच इज मीडिएटेड बाय द और विच इज हेल्प्ड बाय द सेल्स. इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी, CMI. ओके, दिस इज ह्यूमरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेज आर जनरेटेड बाय द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स. ठीक है, ह्यूमरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेज HIR, ये भी लिख सकते हो आप. ह्यूमरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्सेज आर जनरेटेड बाय द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स मीन्स द ह्यूमरल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी दैट इज थ्रू द एंटीबॉडीज दैट इज क्रिएटेड बाय द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स. वेयर एज विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सेल्स इफ एनी टाइप ऑफ द इम्यूनिटी लाइक दैट ऑफ द लिम्फोसाइट्स WBCs में वो अगर कोई आगे फर्दर एक्शन क्रिएट कर रहे हैं अगेंस्ट अ पैथोजेंस दैट इज सेल्स की मदद से अगर इम्यूनिटी क्रिएट हो रही है वी कॉल इट एज सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी दैट इज CMI विच इज क्रिएटेड बाय द टी लिम्फोसाइट्स. ओके, क्लियर. सो दिस इज द इननेट एंड द एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी. फर्दर गोइंग टू द एंटीबॉडीज एंड इट्स स्ट्रक्चर. व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एंटीबॉडीज? एनी डाउट टू एनीवन टिल दिस स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज आई विल बी ड्रॉइंग राइट नाउ. हाँ जी, एनीवन हैविंग एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी डाउट, एनीथिंग नॉट अंडरस्टूड फ्रॉम हियर? ऑल क्लियर, नो प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके, सो कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट इज दैट इज व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस एंटीबॉडीज. जो अभी हमने यहाँ पे बोला तो एंटीबॉडीज जो एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी प्रोवाइड कर रही है दीज एंटीबॉडीज आर known to show the H2L2 structure. What is this H2L2 representation? Means it has two of the heavy chains and two of the lighter chains. Okay, heavy chains means the longer chains and the lighter chain means the smaller chains. Okay, so this structure also it has a specific specificity towards the pathogens. Okay, the specific structure is also produced through this. So these are the two longer chains you can see. The two longer chains or the two heavy chains. Okay, right. It is connected with the disulfide bonding with the lighter chains. So these are the two light chains. So that is why it is called as H2L2 representation of a structure. This is the antibodies that which are created. A structure of an antibody. Okay. In this, if first we label this, it is a light chain and a heavy chain. Two light and two heavy chains. Done. The both together they are also associated with the disulfide bonding. Disulfide bonding bhi hoti hai inke andar. That is SS bond, disulfide bond. You know, if you remember in your biomolecules, we have also considered these structures. They also show the SS bonding in themselves also. ठीक है, अपने में भी उनकी SS bonding बीच में present होती है. That is SS bonding present within the own structure as well. These are antigen specific. ठीक है, like this, and similarly here also, you will show the disulfide bonds. This is what I'm making is like this, S, S, like this. Okay, if not visible properly. So it is SS bonds, right? Similarly, this is having the SS bond in itself as well as by the light and the heavy chains. Okay. At the tip, they have the specific site for their antigens. So we always say that they are antigen specific antibodies. Okay, the specificity lies over here. ठीक है, so this is actually the site. आप simple इसको site को इस तरह से show कर दो because we can't draw the major structures like here. So तो आप सिंपली इसको जस्ट एरोस की फॉर्म में यू कैन शो इट दैट दे आर हैविंग द पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रक्चर्स दैट विच शोज द स्पेसिफिसिटी. आपकी बुक में जैसा बना है आप वैसा भी बना सकते हो, अदरवाइज यू कैन ऑल्सो मेक इट लाइक दिस जस्ट टू शो दैट दे हैव अ स्पेसिफिक स्ट्रक्चर फॉर देयर एंटीजेंस टू विच दे विल बी बाइंडिंग. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एंटीजन बाइंडिंग साइट. ओके, the antigen binding site, there is also SS bonding between these, इनमें भी है आपस में भी है और इसकी अपनी चेन्स में भी है. ठीक है, आपस में भी है और अपनी चेन्स में भी है कुछ इस तरह. यू हैव टू जस्ट रिप्रेजेंट बिकॉज वी आर नॉट एक्चुअली शोइंग द केमिकल स्ट्रक्चर सो वी आर नॉट कंसर्न्ड विद वेयर दी सल्फाइड्स आर गेटिंग चेन बॉन्डेड विद. ओके, सो what was this antibody initially I talked about? What was this antibody? It's a protein, hai na? It is a protein. It's an army of proteins which is secreted by the B lymphocytes. Abhi humne bola, and that is in the form of the antibodies. Okay. For a protein structure, if you remember, in genetics also we have studied. Also in your 11th class biomolecules chapter, you must have studied that the amino acids they are joined together forming the complex proteins like this. है ना, अमाइनो एसिड्स का चेन होता है ना, अमाइनो एसिड 1 to 2 to एनी नंबर ऑफ द अमाइनो एसिड्स विच आर कंबाइंड फॉर्मिंग द पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन्स दैट आर कॉल्ड एज द प्रोटीन स्ट्रक्चर्स. है ना, सो आर दीज एंटीबॉडीज ऑल्सो बिकॉज दे आर ऑल्सो द प्रोटीनिशियस स्ट्रक्चर्स. सो वन थिंग वी ऑल्सो नो दैट इफ द अमाइनो एसिड्स दे आर अरेंज्ड इन दिस मैनर दैट इज वन बॉन्डेड टू द नेक्स्ट देयर इज ऑलवेज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड द एंड टर्मिनल इज फॉर्म्ड and always on the right side the C terminal is formed. You know why? Haji, anybody who knows why there is N terminal on the left side and C terminal on the right side of a chain? Anyone who knows, please raise your hand. नहीं पता. This is basically because of the structure of the amino acid. अमीनो एसिड का फ्री अमीन ग्रुप प्रेजेंट होता है ऑन दिस साइड ऑफ द अमीनो एसिड. अमीनो एसिड्स का जो स्टार्टिंग चेन है जहां से शुरू होता है वहां पे फ्री अमीन ग्रुप प्रेजेंट है और यहाँ पे फ्री कार्बोक्सिल ग्रुप प्रेजेंट है. ठीक है, सो इट मे बी रिटन लाइक दिस इज अ सी चेन, सॉरी सी टर्मिनल ऑफ अ चेन एंड ऑपोजिट टू दिस दैट इज अ एन टर्मिनल ऑफ अ चेन. सो वट डज दिस सी एंड एन रिप्रेजेंट ओवर दिस स्ट्रक्चर? That are the C terminal and the N terminal of the proteinaceous chain. Okay, ये मैंने आपको सिर्फ समझाया था. That is because of the structure of the proteins. हाँ जी, ये clear हो गया. So this is the antibodies that which are produced, and these antibodies are also called as immunoglobulins. We call these as immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins, in short, we can call them as IG. There are varying numbers of the IGs which are produced within our body, and a few of the examples are IgA, IgE, IgM, IgG. Okay, and many more still. So these are the immunoglobulins which are commonly used, IgA, IgE, MnG. So ye hamare paas immunoglobulins hain. What is the other name of the antibodies? That is immunoglobulins. And the different types of the immunoglobulins are listed as these. Any doubt to anyone? Hanji. Next, the types of the immunities based upon their requirements, based upon the sources that from where we get. That is, it is additionally made within our body or we get it from external source. So they are called as the active or the passive immunity, and the vaccinations through that is called as the immunization. Immunization means that is the property by which the immunity is created within our body. Okay, so we will be considering it in the next period. Any question to anyone till this? Anything which is not understood?